My name is Abhiraj Rohil.
I make a video for wastewater technology, one of technologies, electrocoagulation technology. So we are discuss about that electrocoagulation technology. Okay. So I have make a one of simple presentation about the electrocoagulation technology. So we are discuss about electrocoagulation technology is a treatment technology that removes total suspended solid, heavy metals and emulsified oil, bacteria and other contaminants from wastewater like COD and BOD. We are using the electrocoagulation for system as a STP, as a ETP. So today we are focused about the electrocoagulation system in STP, sewage treatment plant. How to work the electrocoagulation treatment? Electrocoagulation technology is treatment process for applying electric current to treat wastewater and make a populant contaminant without having add chemical of coagulation and foagulation. In this system, we are not add the coagulant a chemical without add a chemical coagulant. We apply the electrocurrent on the electron and make a wastewater coagulant. Okay. So moving on, mostly electrocoagulation is removed for a total suspended solid, heavy metals, emulsified oil, bacteria, other contaminants from wastewater like COD and BOD. Okay. So here in how is the work? Okay. So in previous slide we are discuss about the we are applying the electric current. That is in image you can show this anode and cathode. We are apply to electric current and get at the time multiple reaction in this. Okay. Water pass through the electrocoagulation shell and multiple reaction in at the time. First, metal ion is driven into water. If apply the electric current, the metal ion driven into water on a surface of cathode. This is two plates. One of the anode, there is plus, that is a second plate is cathode, this is minus. Okay. So on a surface of cathode, water is hydrolyzed into hydrogen gas and hydrolyzed group. On a surface of water, water is hydrolyzed gas and hydrogen group into hydrolyzed function. Okay. Moving on, meanwhile, the flow of electron is freely to de-established surface of charge on a suspended solid and emulsified oil. The flow of electron freely, the de-established surface charge on a suspended solid and emulsified oil as the reaction continues, the reaction the make a coagulation first and then after large reaction make a foagulation. Then after the wastewater impurity make a large flux about the suspended solid, emulsified oil and finally after the treatment, finally flux are removed from water by filtration process. These flux are removed from the water by the filtration process. I can show you the practical image how to the raw water and how to the we make in water coagulation and foagulation. Okay. And it is the different part of the water. You can see in this image, that is our raw water. Okay, then after we are apply the electric current on the metal, the multiple reaction at the time, the all suspended solid and oil and grease make a flock. First make a cog and after that make a flocks. And you can see the flocculation, the make a larger flock on surface about. And in behind you can see the fresh water. That is both are different part. Okay. In the bottom side you can see the water and above the side you can see the flocks. That is a flocks. It is removed from the water after the filtration process. Okay. So in this image we can understand that first we apply the electric current on anode and cathode. After that the multiple reaction take place at the one at type, multiple reaction at the take place and one on at the one of time. First metal iron driven into water on a surface of cathode. Water is hydrolyzed into hydrogen gas and hydrogen group. Meanwhile, electron is flow freely and de-establish surface charge on suspended solid and emulsion oil. As the continuous reaction first make a coagulation, then the all impurity suspended solid emulsion is come out the nearest on coagulation, and then after continuous reaction make a flocculation. Okay, now moving on. About EC, the exclusive wastewater treatment process is form of electrolyzed term electrocoagulation that reduces electrocoagulation process is reduced fat, oil, grease, chemical oxygen demand, that means COD, from wastewater stream. The process environment friendly as it is does not require addition any chemical. In this process, we are not required any addition chemical for a coagulant and flocculant. The process provide up to 99% efficient remove the oil and grease and 85% remove the COD. This integrate into growing pollutant cluster casing in the become bionet. Electrocoagulation is the electrochemical method of treating pollutant fluid, whereby sacrifice anode chloride, release the and activate coagulant, casing a pollutant to cluster together in a semi solid. This accompanies by the gas release on the cathode. Okay, as are same we are previous discussion about the image. Okay, now we are compare about the conventional process. If you say the put in MBBR media, moving bed bioreactor media, so if that process is we are called to MBBR process. So we are discuss about the conventional process versus MBBR process versus electrocoagulation process. And now we are in this slide we can write MBBR versus electrocoagulation comparison. In MBBR need to normal temperature around 35 to 50 degree because the bacteria growth on this temperature easily on 35 degree and 50 degree easily the bacteria is growing. If below the 35 degree bacteria is not growth, saturation and constant process for a maintain MLSS to 3000 to 6000. But in EC process have a no complaint about the temperature, high, low. Also, EC reactor, we are giving you PP tank reactor. Have a acceptable high degree temperature, 70 degree, and low degree, you can using minus 1, 0 degree, you can using. So they have, EC have a no complaint about the make a wastewater stream, the coagulant and populant process to high low temperature, but in MBBR required the normal temperature 35 to 50 degree, because in this temperature the bacteria is growing in a good grow. But if temperature is high for a 60 70 degree, so the bacteria is dead. If temperature is low below 35, so then condition is bacteria is not growth properly. So if the bacteria is not growth the properly, so organic load, how to absorb the organic load our in wastewater. So the our wastewater quality is not we define the good quality. Okay, moving on. Second point is MBBR bioculture need a take a time 30 days for a startup, then after giving you the result. That means if you establish the MBBR plant, they need to take 30 days for a startup, in first startup, for a growth of bacteria after giving you the result. But in electrocoagulation, you can plug and play and start the system, quick result you can get. Not you can waiting for a 30 days, but quick result you can get. But in MBBR, you can need to 30 days time for a startup, better result for a growth of bacteria, and need to 35 to 50 degree temperature. Once bioculture develop, need to skill people and maintain a knowledge. If the bioculture you can develop, so then maintenance of the MLSS, you can need the skill people. But in electrocoagulation, not require the skill people. This is plug and play process. You can start, make a plug and start the switch. The reactor is on and you can get the output result. So not required the mainly skill about the develop the culture and maintain the biological growth and the bacteria growth, that not required the MLSS. Okay. Second thing in this fourth point, if somehow bioculture lost, if of somehow we are lost bioculture, so repeat cycle we need to 30 days. But in electrocoagulation process, we cannot face this type of issue. But in MBBR, if you get the conventional process, if the bioculture is lost, so repeat cycle, we can get the 30 days process. Next, moving on, continue that the MBBR in electrocoagulation comparison. In this fifth number is space is required more. In this electrocoagulation, less space required. Chemical dosing, there are three types. In chemical free, need only settling for a larger flock polymer, okay, in the settling tank. I can discuss about the layout and discuss on this, what about how to process the electrocoagulation on layout. That is not automatic possible, that is possible in automatic. 8 point, skill manpower require minimum 2 to 3 people. No need require the need only one manpower, but not skill manpower. Okay, maintenance cost is highly, like blower and diffuser breakdown. If your blower is breakdown in oily oil about the part and not required in this about the maintenance. Okay. In this maintenance in MBBR is highly for a blower and diffuser breakdown. If the air is come out by the blower, if diffuser is broken out, so that MBBR is process our breakdown. Okay, but in this case we are not facing this type of issue. The system efficiency is very less, but in this system efficiency is very high. Okay, in electrocoagulation is system efficiency is very high and low space required. Okay. Next, in this slide, we are discussing about the COD reduction with the EC system for a sewage water. Remove a COD by 70 to 80% in single step. Sewage and sludge COD range. Inlet sewage COD range is 500 mg per liter. With EC, that will be reduced 100 mg per liter. After that, we are put the second step is like dual media filter. Yeah, if you are make ozonator, BOD is also reduced proportionally. Treated water confirm to discharge standard from pollution control board. Okay. So in by the electrocoagulation we can reduce the COD 70 to 80% in single step. Our sewage standard parameter inlet COD is 500 ppm. With the EC, only EC, one step, single step, we can get the outlet for 100 ppm. After that, we can feed the water into like dual media filter for we are giving you the 3000 iodine, high carbon activated carbon iodine. Your other options, I have a ozonator system. Then after we can get the COD reduction about 30 ppm. Okay, let's moving on next. In this slide, we can discuss about electrocoagulation plant advantage. So in this, we are not required for aeration, no blower required. Only bottom side we can require by compressed air for continuous plate cleaning. Compact plant save a 60% space. Run effective, very cool climate condition as well as in previous we are discussed about the no temperature complaint. In very cool temperature they are run effectively, but in conventional and MBBR process, bioculture process is run not effectively and very cool climate. But in electrocoagulation we are running to this system very cool climate. Modular and prefabricate use only electricity. We are use only electricity for a sludge setter. Khali only use where we are use only polymer for a sludge settling and make larger flocks. Okay, make a recycle for a sewage reality. Few minutes treatment process, that is a few minutes treatment process, like plug and play process. We can start the switch on and that's a retention time 2 minutes 4 minutes approx that. Okay, 100% chemical free process, smell free process, plug and use, switch on, switch off. Save on capital cost and operating cost, time also save a time. Treatment is effectively. Again, we moving on about the highlight points about the electrocoagulation plant. Some highlight point in this instant treatment in bioculture MBBR conversion system, they are take too much time, but that is the instant treatment. Plug and use, easy to install, no blower, no aeration required, no smell, no chemical add to process. Can be located on the rooftop slaller, small footprint, 40% against the conventional percent. We are save the 40% space against the conventional process. Goodbye to large civil work. We are goodbye to large civil work. Construction and stabilization time. Save manpower, single ship operation, fresh water purchased by recycle, savers charge, independent of the climate and temperature. We are independent on climate and temperature. Obviously previously we have discussed about that. Operating cost, operate only effluent available. Capital cost, we are saved the 60% on larger capacity like 100 kld and 200 kld compared to conventional conventional treatment. We are save the capital cost on larger capacity, but in the 5 kld 10 kld we are not getting the more capital cost, more capital cost save in the small capacity like 5 KLD 10 KLD, but in larger capacity 100 KLD and 200 KLD we are save the capital cost. Okay, now we are discuss about the electrocoagulation technology STP plant. One of technical offer we are always giving to our customer and OEM or our environment consultant, we are giving to. So we are discuss about one of my have a 12 KLD offer. So we are discussing about that. We are giving you inflation transfer pump that is submersible type that make is Kiloskar as a standard in India. Okay, we are also refer our diagram, flow rate diagram. The collection tank, it is a client scope, make in civil. As usual, we can collect the sewage water in this collection tank. That is our inflation transfer pump. That is our EC reactor. That is our settling tank. And that is a sludge settling polymer for a dosing tank and dosing pump. In this, we are put the agitator, dosing agitator for mixing a polymer. In this, we are put the agitator for mixing a polymer. And dosing pump drop by drop outlet for a dosing in settling tank and sludge is settled and output come also make a larger flocks, then water is outcome by the pump and go to the filter press. That filter cloth is 5 to 10 micron. Okay, so all sludge, liquid sludge is break in the filter cloth and fresh water is coming to intermediate tank. This you can make as usual your wish, make a civil, also you can make the HDP as you wish. In this pump you can take after that, this is single step process, you can reduce that 80% COD in this process. Okay, if you are standard sewage you can inlet the 500 COD and outlet you can come to 100 COD. After that the water is storage in intermediate tank and pump is collect the intermediate tank, you can inlet DMF, dual media filter. We are giving you a carbon 3000 iodides, that is second step. You can get the result in outlet that 30 ppm COD. So you can feed the water either, then you can put the ozonator system. You can put the DMF, yeah, you can put the ozonator system. If you put the DMF, then after we are giving you the UV system for a disinfection system. Okay, so this is our layout, inlet to outlet. Okay, inlet collection tank client scope, intermediate if you make the civil and HDBS client scope, that storage capacity giving you different type of flow rate of the sewage. And that storage is different type of flow rate sewage, that is electric panel. Okay, so now going on the, so we are discussing about the technical our offer, that is very about the flow rate. These are the 12 KLD, if you are 10 KLD, 100 KLD, 80 KLD, 50 KLD, so all the technical details vary about on the flow rate. Okay, so nominally we are take example for a 12 KLD inflation transfer pump submersible type, that is on this layout we are discuss, that is that inflation transfer pump, but in submersible this is mount in collection tank. Okay, for your information, EC tank MOC we are giving you PP, that is a PP tank. Okay, also I have an image about that, so I can give you in this picture, that is a sewage raw. First we can EC reactor, after the EC reactor take a glass coagulant, and then after filter press we can get the result. In the larger image we can go to see raw after EC reactor and after filter press. Okay, in this we are giving you polypropylene tank 50 mm thickness, That's life around 10 to 15 years. Simona Gray, we are due to electrode aluminum. After the order, we are giving you electrode size and etc. number of electrode. Cleaning system air sourcing by compressor in the inlet cleaning system. We are air sourcing. Wiring and cable are all put are copper. The support system of PP tank. We are support to PP tank. That is MS. I can give you the image by a larger. Just hang on. This is our PP tank, Simona Gray, and this is our skid support system. Okay, skid support system. That is our PP tank. Okay. Now moving on. We are giving you settling tank is MACP 6 mm. We are giving you a PLC base and high duty fiberglass copper wire with float sensor. Okay, not magnetic sensor, sorry. With float sensor we are giving you 3-phase supply, auto and manual panel. In this picture you can see the panel photo. That all the component is Schneider and L&T make. Okay, that is the settling tank. That is 1 HP we are after the on the flow rate where the HP is vary about. We are giving you the filter pump. That's mean in layout we can see this. That is the filter pump. You can show also is the mud type pump, because in this we are not somehow in small capacity we have settled the sludge during the bottom side and somehow is make a large flux by a poly and direct driven to by the pump filter press. In this 100 kg 200 capacity 200 kg capacity we are make a larger flux, not settle in the sludge in bottom and go to driven to water in the filter press by a pump. And some small capacity 5-10 kld we are settle the sludge and above the surface the clean water get the pump and give to final filtration for a filter press and get the final filtration in intermediate storage tank. Okay, so again we are giving to UV system. In this we are going to show that UV system, that is UV system for a disinfection in water bacteria like that. We are giving you air compressor for cloth cleaning and air sourcing. In this we are for air compressor for plate cleaning and also air compressor one of line is cloth cleaning. Okay, that is the filter press. This size is vary about the flow rate on 100 kg, 200 kg, 12 kg, so vary about type, manual, automatic. Plate MOCPP structure, that is the MS structure, plate MOCPP cloth. Now we are talking about that we are see to the filter press image. That is the PP cloth, that is a MOC support, MS support, PP cloth, that is a clean water you can outlet and after the open the filter press the sludge trap sludge is released from bottom side. In this below the level we can put the tray and open the filter press and the release the trap sludge in bottom side and fresh water you can get that in this side. Okay, this is the fresh water after the filtration. This is our practical image. EC panel, this is the reactor. In this reactor is the MSCP. But in HTP we are giving the PP, that's life is 10 to 15 years. That is our settling tank. Okay, EC panel, that is our raw water after the coagulation after the filtration water. Okay, we are talking about now we are talking about the operating cost in simple presentation. In this the photo you can see before after first EC reactor treatment and after filter press treatment the image. as usual, we are talking about previously the DC power given to electrode and make a larger coagulation population, no added chemical, that's the same. We are just talking about that panel image and about the function, that same layout we can discuss about it. That is comparison in we are previous talk about in slide. That is in the advantage we are talking about it. In this we are talking about the operating cost. In this we are talking about the sludge transfer, filter, feed pump, about the power supply, EC power supply, that's a kilowatt, we can air compression kilowatt, poly dosing per kilowatt, and we are working our design that our plant is 20 hour and working day per day, we can find that kilowatt, total kilowatt we can find 131 kilowatt per day. On the, we are counting in Indian rupees, 7 rupees per unit price in India. So we can give the in USD, you can reach the 1000 liter. So that 0.4 paisa USD, 0.4 USD you can pay the operational cost for a standard STP sewage water. Approx we are giving you to the standard STP plant we are consider for that, with including plates, with including electricity, with including monthly maintenance, with including yearly maintenance. We can count in yearly maintenance, we can count the yearly maintenance, filter place, cloth, you can this. And the monthly maintenance, we can count the aluminum plate per kg and the oil for air compressor, monthly counting. And daily counting about the electricity, okay, and polymer, okay. So all this included cost, if you are take a 1000 liter treated your sewage water, so you can pay 0.4 USD. If you treat 100 meter cube per day, so that cost you can 35 USD. Okay, per day 100 meter cube you can sewage water treat, so approx 35 USD you can pay. Approx, after depend on your locality for electricity per unit charges. We are count the electricity about the Indian charges. Okay. Thank you for watching this the video. I hope you can understand about the Nakheel water, the electrocoagulation STP plant. Thank you.